Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Good morning, student. How are you today?
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Good morning, ma'am.
I'm fine. Thank you. How about you?
I'm very well. Thank you. Who is absent today? Nobody is absent, ma'am. Good job. Now, before we start studying, who will lead the prayer? Okay, Fajrin, Muhammad Fajrin.
Yes, ma'am. Before we start learning, let's pray together. Finish.
Okay, thank you, Fajrin. Anybody knows what we are going to learn today? Laili Fatmawati, do you know?
I don't know, ma'am.
Okay, it's okay if you don't know. Ma'am, we'll tell you about our activity today. Our goal and activity today is to learn word substitution with the subject to be and replace word with synonym. Do you got it, kids?
Yes, ma'am, we got it.
Yes, ma'am, we got it.
Are you ready to study?
Of course, ready to study.
Of course, ma'am.
Okay, good. Let's start and listen carefully, yeah? Okay, first, ma'am will explain about to be. To be is used as a link between the subject and the predicate. However, that does not mean we can just connect it. There is something that needs to be known in advance about what to be should be used according to the subject of a sentence. We can see in share screen. Subject I, to be, used to be am. Subject they, we, you, used to be are. And subject she, he, it, used to be is. First, am can only be used for subject that refer to the first person singular where there is only one, namely I. To be are can be used for two kinds of point of view, including the subject in the second person point of view and all the subject in view. We usually know the subject as the word you. As for the plural point of view, we usually know the subject as the word we and they. Is usually used when the subject is third person singular. This use of is can only be applied to a single third person such as, for example, he, or mom, she, female, and it noun. Okay. To be perfect, in English, which are used as connecting words between subject and noun. The sentence structure is listed in the following formula. Subject plus to be plus noun. S for subject, to be for am, are, is, noun for object. Okay. Does anyone have something to ask before we move forward? No?
I have a question, ma'am. My question is, why do we have to use to be in English, ma'am?
Okay, good question, Nadia. To be has an important function that is as a connecting word between the subject and the predicate in order to form a good sentence. If there is no to be, then the sentence is not good. Do you got it, Nadia?
Okay, ma'am. Thank you.
You're welcome. To make it easier for you to understand, I provide an example. You can take a look at the share screen. Now, example one, he is a football player. And you can see that he as the subject, is as the to be and football player as the noun. Okay, next example. Example two, she is an architect. Then for this sentence, she as the subject, is as the to be and architect as the noun. Okay, example three. It is a cat. It as the subject is as the to be and cat as the noun. To know you understand, I want each of you to mention which is the subject, to be an object in this sentence in every example. Start from Sunita. I want you to mention which is the subject, to be an object in this sentence. Remember of your meat, go on.
For example, for the sentence is, there are teachers, so they as the subject, or as the to be, and teachers, and the noun.
Very good. Clap your hand for Sunita. Next, I want Nikmah Ajijah for example 5.
Yes, ma'am. For example 5, the sentence is we are student, so we as the subject are as the to be and student as the noun.
Excellent. Good. Next, who wants? Who?
Me, ma'am.
Okay, Lily.
For example 6, the sentence is, you are a pilot, so you as the subject are as the to be and pilot as the noun.
Well done. For the last, I want to Fajrin. Okay, Fajrin.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. Example 7.
For example 7, the sentence is I am a student, so I as the subject, am as the to be, and student as the noun.
Great. All of you are correct to mention which is the subject, to be an object in this sentence. Let's clap everyone. Good. Does anyone have something to ask before we move forward?
Nope, ma'am.
Nope, ma'am.
Okay. Before we forward to next topic, there is a little ice breaking to boost your spirit. Okay, follow me.
If you're happy and you know it, clap your hands. If you're happy and you know it, clap your hands. If you're happy and you know it, and you really wanna show it. If you're happy and you know it, clap your hands. If you're happy and you know it, stomp your feet. If you're happy and you know it, stomp your feet.
Next topic is about synonym or similar words. Synonyms are used inside a word but have the same meaning without change the meaning of the sentence. The words that are replaced are in the form of adjective, verb, and noun. For the example, Ma'am has beautiful flowers in the front yard of the house. And beautiful is an adjective and can be changed into other words that have the same meaning like adorable, dazzling, gorgeous, etc. Another example again. He can make amazing drawing on the wall. Amazing can be changed into other words that have the same meaning like incredible, unbelievable, etc. This also applies to verb and nouns as well. More synonyms you can read and search in the dictionary. It's very easy. You got it, kids? Any question?
Yes, got it, ma'am.
I have a text for you. Prepare a set of paper and a pen, then answer the question in the share screen. Are you ready, student?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, let's we start. Number one, who is want to answer?
Me, ma'am.
Okay, Pajrin, what is your answer?
Number one, she and he are supportive and kind-hearted. The answer is they.
Okay, good. Number two.
Ayun, ma'am.
Nikmah Ajijah, yes.
Okay. The answer to number two is A. She, ma'am.
Okay, correct the answer. Next, number three. Who is answer? Okay, number three.
Ayun, ma'am.
Yes, Nadia Fabrina, please.
OK.
Okay, for the text number 3, he and I are happy to have a birthday party. The answer is C, we mean.
Good answer. Next, number 4.
I won, ma'am.
Okay, Laili Fatmawati, please.
My brother is educator. Educator, the synonym is C, teacher. The answer is C.
Teacher. Okay, smart answer, yeah. Next, number 5. Okay, number 5. Who want to answer? Sunita?
Yes, ma'am. Number 5. Don't eat this mushroom. It is danger. The answer is dangerous. B.
Oh, good answer. Next. Number 6. Number 6. Who won the answer?
I won, ma'am.
Okay, Nima Ajija. What is...
Okay. City has beautiful face. The answer is... She. The Jiling, ma'am.
Okay, correct. Good. Next, number 7. Come on, number 7.
I won, ma'am.
Yes, Nadia.
For number 7, my house is big. The answer is B.
B? Good answer. Okay, number 8.
I won, ma'am.
Yes, Laili Fatmawati.
The answer is A. Humorous.
Yes, very funny. The answer is A. Humorous.
A. Yes. Okay, yes.
Good. Good. Number 9.
I won, ma'am.
Yes, Sunita. What the answer?
Number 9. He has a big house. The answer is love. C.
Love. Okay, good. And the last. Number 10.
Me, I won.
Okay, Fajrin. What's your answer?
Number 10, my girlfriend is very picky. The answer is C, ma'am, beautiful.
Okay, good. Nice, all of your answer are correct. Clap your hand for everyone. Okay. Before we close the lesson, who wants to conclude what lesson we got today? Okay, who?
Me, ma'am.
Yes, Nima Ajija, please.
Okay, ma'am. Today we learn about the use of to be and synonym in English, ma'am.
Okay, nice answer. I hope our lesson today can be useful for all of you here. Let's pray together after the lesson. Finish. We will meet in the next lesson. Remember to always be passionate about learning. Thank you, students.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am.
You're welcome. Bye-bye. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam.
Alhamdulillah. Thank you.